Hello, this is Sandra Carr-Moore, and in my day-to-day life, I aim to look at the situations and the scenarios and to see how they intertwine and interact with the development of a quality management system. I know generally we think, when we think about quality management systems, we think about a company, but it translates to the individual, where you have your own personal goals and standards that you decide, ways that you decide that you're going to behave that will represent and speak to your character and who you are. So I had this experience with my car. I insured my car with a company, and I was driving on my way home, my then spouse and my daughter, my youngest daughter, they were in the car with me. It happened at a stoplight, and so right, you know, generally when you when you're coming up on a stoplight, there's a little division, and there is a ruled area or a painted area that comes up to a separation in the road, right? And when I was in a line of traffic and I was proceeding to come out of the line to another line that was expanded from the merged line, and I looked behind me, I did not see any vehicle coming at all. And before I could even proceed outside of the lane, a van came and tore off half of the front of my front bumper. And the matter was reported, and the insurance companies, they received the file and the claim and stuff. Now this is like many years ago, and I'm finding it challenging in my day-to-day activities to confirm that companies and individuals are truly committed to quality standards, to behaving in a proper way, to doing what is right, to pleasing their customers. I'm not expecting companies to please their customers at the expense of their own longevity. No, that is not what I'm expecting, but I'm expecting some level of commitment so that everybody can experience a level of win-win. Now, I am at a situation now where I am unable to get any money for the repair of my bumper. I have since over the years been doing the little damages, repairing the damages over time. I'm still unable to get my car up and running, right? And I've received no monies, no payment, no explanation from the insurance company, only some word to say that offering a 50-50 proposal, meaning that I would accept 50% liability for the accident. Now, based on my take of the whole thing, because I don't understand how this gentleman can have another take, because he is in a van which is higher than I am, and if he is coming in a van, he has a better view, a vantage point than I do to see me coming. So I'm saying, how is he coming at such a speed in such a short space, so that the collision would result in the tearing and ripping of my metal bumper. It's a metal bumper, right? And so just the whole, not to mention the fact that I'm a female driver, I'm not a man, you know, I'm a female driver, and that even speaks volume. At the time I received my license a little over a year, which speaks volumes. And I'm just really frustrated because I got a 6 weeks contract, and believe me, it was like torture to take the public transportation. I mean, like literal torture. I literally passed out in the bus at one particular time, and in other instances I became dizzy. I'm a little bit claustrophobic, and I really don't really like having a lot of things and people all up in my personal space. So I'm using this as an opportunity to vent, Because I have reported a number of issues to the police, and it might seem that I am a troublemaker, but seeing that no one is hearing or listening or doing anything about the challenges that I am faced with, I have no other option but to vent in this fashion. And you can share your stories, because this is a sore point and a sore matter, and we have to work on our level of quality in the country, in our lives, in the world. It is poor. It is poor. And sometimes I get the feeling that it is a cry for help. But I'm convinced that there have been persons in all of our lives who have impacted and created and began the work of quality development in our lives and in our companies. And when you deliberately try and show yourself as low quality, as a cry for help, you are really just, yeah, this them. You're making them feel as if they wasted their time. You are discouraging the new persons who are coming on, who are absolutely sure that the persons of former days were good at their jobs and did a good work. And now when you are coming in into a situation where you have new blood, young blood, you're trying to get free work, and so you muck up their normal, simple application processes. I mean, it's ridiculous. It's totally ridiculous. The investment in the company is not only in the purchasing of equipment. It's not only in the purchase of equipment and services and sales. It is also in the development of documentation which expresses and shows quality standards that needs to be applied so that the customers can be happy. The services and the product development can move faster, and in return that will result in more profit, because at the end of the day we're all in business to make money. So how on earth you are going to slow up and behave in a way that cause less people? How are you going to slow up and cause less people to get served, which means less money coming in, and then expect an increase in pay, increase in income, increase when you're doing less? You know, I don't get it. So those are my few words, and I'm going to stop here, because you know this is a very sore point, a very passionate sore point on my part. Blessings, and please, I beg you, it's not easy. You're not alone. Just be the best version of you. That's all you can do. Nobody's perfect. Be the best version of you, and you'll be fine. All right, one step at a time, one day at a time. Peace.